Okay, back on the next part of the magna rail for the container terminal. Now, as you can see, I have a very long run of magna rail with two motors. So this motor here is pulling all the way around here and all the way down up to this fella. And then vice versa, this one's pulling the chain all the way around there and all the way back up to the other one. Now I'm going to add two more motors, which is like so, and they're going to be probably about there just to help pull it around the corner or the loop. And the same up the other end. Now, in my test, it seems to be going okay, but I just don't want to lay the roadbed over the top and then find out later on that these two motors are going to struggle. But I'll turn it on for you. And it seems to be turning okay, but just to be on the safe side, I'm going to add the two motors, and it may make it run better, I don't know. Sometimes when I'm running the semis on it, you'll get a jerk. So the plan is add two motors, so I'm going to do that, and then I'll show you the difference. Okay, I've just put the two extra motors in, and I'm just running the chain. And also up the other end. I'll just speed it up. Okay, I thought I'd show you how I picked the magnets in the semis. Now, as you can see, this is a little 3mm square magnet. And what I've done is I've put a bit of magna rail chain link and glued it to the base of the semi, and then put the 3mm square magnet in, as you can see. Now also on my chain, there's another 3mm square magnet in the chain. So that's what runs the semis. I can't remember if I told you how I put the magnets in the semis. In the cars I used a smaller magnet. That's what I used. Okay, down with some roadbed to see how the semis go.